Pirates of the 20th Century.
Well, the cargo is now yours.
Please.
You know, Captain, it is regrettable that you can't be free for a day or two. There's a very profitable cargo for Japan.
Sorry, but our firm is very interested in this opium.
Is all this opium for one factory?
There's a certain country that needs the shipment.
So it's straight home.
Yes. Straight home.
Thank you.
Nicholas Eremenko as the chief engineer. Pyotr Velyaminov as the captain. Algat Digmatulin as Sala. And Reino Aren as the pirate captain.
Engine full stop. Lower the number one lifeboat.
How's he doing?
Did he say who he was?
I can't tell. He's so weak, he can't even talk.
You mean he didn't have his visiting cards with him, huh?
If we didn't pick him up when we did, he would have been a goner.
I guess he was scared.
Well, wouldn't you be? The sharks are hungry this year.
Koja is, too.
Marconi, the radio chief wants to see you right away.
All right, I'm going.
Did you make that up?
What's that?
The line about the radio chief.
Of course I did.
Come on over here and sit down. Here. This is important. Salah. Speak to me. No, no. Yeah, I'll give you something.
Salah.
Gosha.
Salah.
Hello. Hello.
Salah. Welcome on board.
Leave some for him.
Warm me up.
That's true. Russian soup. Go on, try it.
His name is Salah.
Thank you.
Here.
Thank you.
So tell us, Salah, did you have to swim a long way?
Oh, yes, I did.
You know, I think we do better with the chief engineer here.
Right.
Then why don't you go and get him, huh?
Yeah.
And leave me some soup, huh? Come in.
Sergei,
we need your help topside.
Okay.
Well, that's our shipwrecked sailor.
Looks like he's recovering.
He's eating now.
Have him see me when he's finished.
Right.
What was the name of your ship?
Samuel de Carlston. We were sailing from Sydney to Yokohama. With cotton.
So, you were on the Samuel de Carlston. I guess something must have happened along the way.
You must have had a rough time.
What happened to the ship?
the cotton. Caught fire. It spread to the deck. It was a lot of panic. The crew began fighting for the life belts and for room in the lifeboats.
You say the cotton in the hold caught fire and it spread through the rest of the ship. And if they hadn't panicked, there probably would have been more survivors.
When did all this happen?
Do you remember?
Yesterday, in the afternoon.
So he's been in the water for 20 hours. Do you think there were other survivors?
Do you think there's any chance of picking up more survivors? If you give us the approximate coordinates, then we could contact all the ships in the area. Yes?
Captain, we've just sighted a ship dead ahead of us. Distance half a mile.
I'm coming. Nobody on deck watch, no one on the bridge that I can see. Looks intact. Doesn't seem to be any damage.
No flags on her either.
What do you think could have happened?
The crew must have abandoned the ship.
Lower the lifeboat.
Lower the lifeboat.
Shall I take charge, Ivan?
All right, take two men with you, the chief engineer. Find out if it's anything mechanical.
Aye, aye.
You go along, Vladimir, and call us as soon as you find the radio. Don't everybody go aboard. Leave two men in the lifeboat.
Right.
I always thought that phantom ships only existed in kiddies' tales.
No matter what we do, you always boil everything down to a horror story.
Well, we'll soon find out what's going on.
Slow ahead.
I can't see our men on the bridge anymore.
Just like a joke on us.
Maybe we're in the Bermuda Triangle.
Thank you.
the stern, now.
Well, that seems to have gone along pretty well.
You had it figured just right, Captain.
I knew they'd fish you out of the drink.
Our friends are relaxing, Captain. We've locked them up in the cabins.
Unload as quick as you can, Schweider.
Right.
You want to know what I think?
I don't care what you think. I'm doing the thinking. Now, do you understand that? Why, are you having second thoughts? I'm only joking.
Well, I don't like jokes, Captain.
Opium. Thank you.
on, move it. Now take it easy there. And watch out for the detonator, you slobs. We don't want to sink with the Russians, do we?
The dynamite goes down to the engine room.
That's it. All right, take her up. Keep down. Fall on your belly. On your belly. You hear? Go on.
Keep on, keep on. I found the women. They're locked in the library.
The library. Get to the lifeboat. Quick.
Take a deep breath.
fall.
Here, grab hold. Grab hold.
It won't be long now, and the pirates will see us there. What are we going to do, Ivan?
What can we do, huh?
We can always take a bubble bath. There are plenty of them.
Give me a flare.
Should pull out now,
Captain. Full speed ahead.
Full speed ahead.
You know, Captain, it would really surprise me if we can row against the current.
Yes. We're being swept to the southwest.
Well, if that's the case, we're getting further and further away from the shipping lanes.
Thank you.
machine gun.
Always raid the storage room. What would you like for starters? Caviar.
Now we know where we stand.
But what are we going to do? Give up?
Fight.
Fight with what?
What about this? Or this?
We can't fight machine guns with flare pistols.
Thank you.
repeats a question. How many men are left on the ship? I'll give you 1 minute.
Save him. Is that what happened? What's your name?
Moa.
I'm Sergei. Why did you kill him?
Our people had lived here a long time. When their ship came, we were just a small tribe of pearl fishermen. They started by killing our men. After that, they attacked our women. And that one, he killed my father.
Can you tell us how many of them there are? There are 15 of them? Going to be looking for us soon. We've got to take the ship tonight.
We'll have to take that machine gun, or we'll never get out.
We'll do it, Captain.
Take whatever you need with you.
You coming with me? It isn't going to be easy, you know.
Matveich, I want to come with you.
We might not come back, you know that.
I know.
Here's the way I see it. The women and Kuliev will stay in the cave for the time being. You stay here. Don't move at all. You can't be seen from shore. The cave can only be seen from the water. The pirates can't stay on the island forever. Sooner or later, they have to leave here. When they do, you have to get away from here. Go to the middle of the island. There's fresh water there.
Ivan. Ivan, don't leave me. I want to go too.
All right. You can come along.
Thanks.
Let's all get some sleep now.
Noe! Noe, where are you? Noe!
Contact with the SS Najin has been established in the last 72 hours. Calling all Soviet ships. Extend the searching area to the following coordinates.
Who goes there?
Take it easy. It's Stanko. Igor Mikhailovich. I was born in 1959. Russian sailor. I'm lost. Can you give me something to eat?
Throw your guns over. Go to the radio shack. Them up in the hold.
Is he alive?
Not for long. If only I had a grenade.
And blow up the radio?
In there.
go get the captain.
Yeah, right away.
I'd like to speak to the captain, if I may.
He's eating lunch. He told me not to disturb him.
Are you in the habit of serving peas for lunch?
So he honors us with his presence.
How's it going, Captain?
Bastard shooting like he'll never run out of ammunition. That's fine. Keep up the good work.
I'm very happy to see you, Captain.
You can forget the formalities. This isn't the time or place.
I have a proposition to make to you. Do you see this motor launch? It's yours. I'll give you some fuel, a compass, and charts, too. And you can get the hell out of here. I'm attached to my men. There aren't many of them left now.
There are fewer of them than you think.
Ivan, the radio's ready.
The times when you could dictate your conditions are all over for you now. The radio transmitter is ours.
I hate to spoil your fun, Captain. But you don't have a radio. Things aren't what they seem. It's not going to be that easy for you and your ship. There's only one way out of here. And I'm the only one who can pilot you. However, I don't feel like working for you as a pilot. And last but not least, and as you can see, we have the other girl, too. Everything depends on you, Captain. The decision is yours. And if you want to make their stay pleasant, you'll think over my proposition. You have till 12 tonight. All right, let's go. All right, let's get out of here.
Gotta find a way through that channel, Sergei.
There's too many rocks. It's difficult to see how they found their way out.
A miserable situation.
The ebb tide is due in 2 hours now. Maybe we could make use of it.
And leave the girls?
We can't leave them here. We all know that. If we can make it out to the open sea, then we'll at least have a chance. We can't go along with any one of their conditions. They'll never let their motor launch go. We know too much already. They don't want witnesses.
It's open.
You better check that the anchor is fast.
Right.
Looks like the captain's personal file. Sada, alias Li Guan, alias Ngong Chu. Has ties with Hong Kong, Macau, Singapore. Three ships to his credit. A professional terrorist, hunted by Interpol for the hijacking of a Boeing 747 and the murder of some of the passengers. Broke out of Saigon jail while serving time. While escaping, killed the guard, strangled him. Insensitive to pain. Drinks like a fish, but can hold it. Very obvious sadistic tendencies. His weaknesses, narcotics and women. A maniac, waits for just the right time before moving in for the kill.
He's a real beauty.
Second, Joachim Johannes, alias Rolf Schneider, alias Kurt Winner, took part in reprisals in Africa, operated in Angola. Sharpshooter, handy with a blade, gets his kicks in odd ways. A pathological liar and very stingy. Hard worker, easy to please for living conditions and food. His weaknesses, he's sentimental. Loves his mother.
We can always complain to his mother.
All fast and 9 meters depth, sir.
9 meters, what is that in feet? Southwest, 100 meters. 10 meters is 33 feet. This marine chart of the area indicates the depths. Maybe we can find our way out with it. I don't like this one bit. It's too quiet.
Seven.
Forward engine stop, starboard engine slow stern.
10 meters.
It's a mine.
Stop! Engines full astern. Don't shoot. If it explodes, the waves will wash us under the rocks. Bosun's mate!
They're coming back.
Want me to get the motor launch?
We have time. But they've decided to agree to all our conditions. Then they'll give us a signal. Don't forget, we're not supposed to know what's going on with them. And we have the two girls with us.
I know what you mean, Captain.
I don't beat women. There are other ways of making them talk.
Well, this is the best way. Peter! 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 If you want to get anywhere, you have to forget your feelings. Stamp them out like snakes. Here, now you go to work. Make her talk. I'm going to go see the other one.
So you've told me everything you've seen on the island. They're both alive, then. Stetsenko!
Yes?
Get the crew together, quick!
Right away, Captain.
Well, about ready to start talking?
Leave me alone, please.
What's wrong? You don't like whiskey? It's very good whiskey.
Speak up!
So you don't know what I mean. Well, you better start learning.
Maybe we should try something else.
Well, they must have taught you something when you were in school. I'll bet you were the best student in your class. Am I right? Let's see how much you learned while you were there. What's the matter? You're shy. We could have a good time together. Hey, Kezi. Do you like her?
Tell her. It's the Russian captain.
The proposition I made to you before still goes. Give me the men and you'll get the girls, plus the motor launch, with all the fuel you'll need. I'm sorry I can't give you any weapons, though. The terms are harder now. You'll never reach the open sea if you don't accept them.
And the ship? Don't forget my people aboard.
That's why I'm offering you the motor launch. Otherwise, I wouldn't have tried to negotiate.
And what if I paid you a decent price? What currency would you prefer? Dollars? Pounds? Perhaps you'd like marks.
So you know where we hide our cash. I should have suspected it from the way you came sailing into the channel with so much assurance.
Don't get any ideas, Captain. I had the crew put a can of gasoline in your cabin. The last one left alive will set fire to it.
You are a very clever man, Captain.
I'm going to try to live up to that compliment.
Put yourself in my place. That opium really belongs to us. The dealers will pay us a good price for it. What I'm offering you is something more valuable, much more precious, Captain. Your life.
It would be very easy for you to chase us, catch us, and ram us.
You don't have any other choice, have you, Captain?
There are plenty of choices. I would prefer to die with honor and at the same time get rid of you.
Oh, don't be so dramatic, Captain. You're an experienced skipper. You can judge for yourself. The ship can't go much faster than the motor launch. And time-wise, you will have a considerable advantage. I'll need time to weigh anchor. After that, I'll need time to sail through the channel. And finally, you know only too well the open sea exit is mined. And demining it will take more time. You'll have a minimum of 1 hour to find your way to the open sea. After that, you'll be able to change your course. And no matter how much I tried, I'd never catch up with you. So what do we decide?
Let me think for a minute. All right. But first, I want the motor launch engine checked and the water and food supply sampled by your men.
And everybody unarmed.
Those are normal terms for an exchange of prisoners.
What interests me most is the cargo. So everything should be completed by 6 a.m. Speed ahead. Give the order. Now we know what to do. We'll give them a great reception.
Okay. Okay, get going.
Okay.
going to need me. I'll do whatever you want. Stick him up! Up, I said! Move!
On your feet!
Transmit an SOS! Make it quick! All right, only don't kill me. I'll do what you want. Who's the door? Find out. What do you want?
The captain wants you, Sala.
All right. What are our coordinates? The coordinates!
Are you coming or not?
All right. Don't open. If you do, he'll shoot. That's enough. On your feet. Move!
Message. Courage on the following coordinates. 7 degrees, 8 minutes, north latitude.